Praise the Lord. Good afternoon if it's afternoon. Good evening if you're finna go to bed. This is the Book of Racq podcast. I'm Racq. Did you have a good day today? Have you had a good day so far? I know it's morning, but by the time you, well, it depends on when you're listening to this. That's why I say it three different. Anyway, I hope you have a good day. I hope that it's been a good week. I hope it. June has been good for you so far. And I want to get into June and the topic at hand for right now, but I do want to address one thing. I've had a lot of people ask me how I'm doing because I have been more vocal about and transparent about my journey in the last couple of months. Days, and it's been very uncomfortable, if I can be quite honest, to be so vocal and so naked about my journey, struggles that I'm dealing with, overcoming battles and all of the different things. But it's been good for me though, for once not having to just hold a bunch of stuff in and not bottle a bunch of stuff up. It's been therapeutic to have the podcast, to have my village of friends and family, my therapist, thank you Jesus, along with prayer and wise counsel. So with all things together, and journaling, of course, with all things together, yes, I'm doing much better today than I was, and I'm grateful. It's something when you choose to no longer be hurt. You know, like you can be upset, you can be hurt, you can be going through life and fighting all kind of things, and you know, life gonna be life in every time. Like everybody has a thing that they're dealing with. Excuse me, and I'll be tired. And the first part of what I need in my healing journey is a week vacation. So if y'all want to get together as my graduation gift at the end of the semester and send me on vacation, I'm appreciate it because I need it. I need a full on vacation so that I can go live my life. Now, why would you embarrass me like that? That's what I need. A full-on vacation. Because the girl is tired. Exhausted, actually. So, anyway. But, yeah. I'm doing much better today than I was. And I'm grateful. And I appreciate y'all praying and thinking and sending check-ins and all the things. It's been really helpful. And I can feel the love when you're reaching out. Whether we talk every day or we don't talk that often, like, I know y'all care and I know that y'all are supporting and are present, and I appreciate it. I appreciate it. Even if I don't verbalize it as much, I appreciate it. It means the world to me. So that's that. But this month is Men's Mental Health Awareness Month, and let me just tell y'all, so at the top of this month, I can't remember if it was last week or the week before. I can't remember. Anyhow, I did a video and put it on Instagram and TikTok, and it really was impressed upon me to encourage women to love on our men this month. Like, pray for them, intercede for them, encourage them, because they are fighting all kind of battles. Like, they're trying to be present for us and, you know, trying to be strong and leaders and all the things. But the reality is they trying to be, you know, depending on where you are, demographic wise, majority of them are trying to be Black men in America. They're trying to stay out of jail. They're trying to, you know, lead their families, not be a statistic. Like, they're really trying to be good guys, you know? And they don't always get it right. And for women, they frustrate the snot out of us some days. And they really, you know, you just be like, you are a good man. And I know you the Lord some, but I just really want to shoot you a kneecap twice and walk away, you know? But we can't do that, you know? So I was just really encouraging, you know, the women to just, let's just love and pray for our men this month. Let's encourage them. Let's get them some counseling if they feel like they want to use counseling. If they don't, let's just be, you know, present for them and love on them, all the things, right? Child, that man said to me, all right, don't y'all be doing all this loving and all things on these men in June and give them hell July 1st. And when he said it, I screamed, because I mean, yeah. So my whole girl was like, yeah, we're going to just bottle up all of our things about y'all and just hold them until July 1st. And then we're going to unload the clip. Because I know you got me messed up if you think I'm going to let that slide just because it's your month. That thing was funny to me, honey. But the reality is, for women, and I've said this before, women, we are emotional beings. Emotional creatures. And the way that we process things and the way that we internalize them can be mixed a lot of times with our emotions. And so they may say one thing to us and we hear it a complete other way, because are you crazy? Like, there's no way you just said that to me the way you did. And in their minds, they don't see nothing wrong with how they say things sometimes. They don't see nothing wrong how they address things sometimes or how they respond to it. And we just be like, why don't you get this? Why don't you understand what I am saying? And how would you respond that way if you did actually understand where I am? And that can cause conflict a lot of days. And that's just not in, you know, a relational or romantic aspect. That could be from a family aspect. It could be work related. However, we have to, and I'm saying this myself, like, we have to as a unit do better with actually learning the art of communication from one to another instead of just talking. Because I'm having to relearn the art of communication. I am. Because the moment where I feel like I am triggered or you have hit a spot and that like gut punch hit, or I feel triggered, I'm like, oh, no you didn't. And it just like darts me very fast. There's a natural defense instantly that comes up. And now I'm ready to nuck and butt, because I just know. Baby, I am Virginia Wyatt's granddaughter. I just know for a fact you didn't think you was about to. You're crazy. And your mama crazy too. Because that's it. No. There's no way you thought you was going to get away with that. So the moment I feel like there's a natural defense, or I feel like that you have pushed a button of mine, I'm responding in full out emotion. I am not thinking logically right now. I'm not thinking with my brain. I'm not thinking with, you know, the Holy Ghost and all of his power. No, thinking about how you finna get these words that's not in the dictionary. Because I know you're playing on my face. Especially if I done sat there and processed and, you know, thought out my things and I tried to take emotion out of it and try to come to you logically, because men are logical, okay? They're not going off of emotional conversations. They think in logic. Their brains are plan it, fix it, execute it. That's the man. Us, we got to break down scenarios. We got to see the bigger picture. We got to imagine. We got to dream it up. It takes us a little. It's nothing wrong with our process at all. But our process is different than the male human being. And so there's a lot of times where women can feel like, did you even hear what I just said? And so we'll shut down. We'll not want to engage anymore, what have you. Anyhow, because this month is Men's Mental Health Awareness Month, I'm trying to do my best by not adding to the wearing of their mental health, if I can say that. That does not mean that I'm being silent or that I am, you know, not being aware and cognizant of my own feelings and my own thoughts, because I am. But does mean that I'm trying my best to not add on the additional pressure and do more self-checks, like, okay, Raquel, are you having a moment here, or does this actually need to be addressed? Like, is it girl week? Have you checked your flow app? Are you okay? Are you ovulating by chance? Why are you crying all the time? Like, are you okay? Before we take this to the other party's presence and ready to, you know, WWE, how about we address it, make sure we're okay first, and then we'll go address. Because, like, I know me at this point, and I thank God for the Holy Ghost. Because at this point, Raquel is doing better with thinking before responding. Oh, my God. The Lord is working, okay? He's doing really, really good in my inner parts. Because hot head Raquel, and not that long ago, you hit the right button, I'm coming for your neck. And your head, you're going to be missing a lash or two. But now, since I'm being worked on, and the Lord is dealing with my inner parts, I am more prone to think first. Raquel, why are you emotional about this? Why are you upset about this? What about this is bothering you? And when I think about that, I'm able to articulate it appropriately. So by the time I articulate appropriately, if you still don't get it now, I gotta get loud. Now I gotta get about it. Because I tried the logical approach. I tried the nice one. I tried the let me break this down for you approach. And you still act like I'm talking Portuguese. So, let me try Ebonics. And I try not to go that way. I try not to go in that area. But I said, he's working on me. I'm in process. I'm not done. And I acknowledge that. Now, there are some areas in my life where I'm just like, absolutely, he completely healed that area. The Lord is kind to me. I'm never going back. There are other areas of my life, I'm like, You may need a little bit more oil over there. Might need a little bit more fasting and prayer in that area specifically. Because I just, you know, some days I just don't know. You know? Either way, it's fine. For the men, though, I think here's my problem, or here's my thing about the men's mental health thing. And I, at some point, will probably interview a male to talk about this. So I think, and I could be very wrong, which is why I want to interview a man. I don't think men always do feel safe enough to be vulnerable or to let their hair down by chance. I think they feel like they have to be guarded, they have to be strong, they have to be in a leadership position, emotionally, mentally, physically, all the time, because they're either, you know, caring for a family, caring for a spouse, caring for a parent, whatever. And in some households, particularly the Black household, and years past, for decades, you know, showing emotion equated to showing weakness. And so you have this generation of hardcore men who, you know, they're great providers and they'll build you a house in 2 days, you know? But when it comes to being in touch or in tune with their emotions or with their feelings, that can be difficult. That can be difficult. And since we are naturally emotional beings, we're like, I've created this safe space for you. I've created, you know, this place for you to let all of your feelings go. Like, I'll keep it as a safe place. I'll be a chest for you. Like, I will lock it down and throw away the key. Like, nobody can have access between me, you, and the Lord. Like, nobody else is gonna know about this right here. And I think we as women want to create that, you know, safety net for them, but they have to, one, feel comfortable enough to lay their woes with you. And then two, and no, let me say A and A1, they also have to be comfortable enough with taking their armor off with you. And then two, you have to be ready to just listen. Because just like men, and I'm horrible at this some days. There's some days I can just listen, and there are other days I'm horrible. Just like with men, sometimes if women come to them, I know for me, if I've come to a man in the past and said, da, 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 their response is, okay, how can we fix it? And I'm like, I just really needed you to listen. Like, I don't need you to do any action right now outside of buy me some food and flowers. Like, I don't need you to do anything. I just need you to listen. Now, tacos, flowers, these are always in order. We need these to make my life better just because it's Tuesday. Yes. But outside of that, like, I don't need you to take any action. And so for women, sometimes we can do the same. If they're coming to us in a vulnerable state, we'll be like, okay, how can I be here for you, babe? How can I be present for you? What can I assist with? Like, we just want to help our man or our men in our life, because the last thing a woman wants to do is see her man or the men in her life broken down, especially when they're generally strong creatures, when they're generally, you know, Mr. Fix It, Mr. Get It Done. Like, don't nothing break him. Don't nothing bother him. Smooth, you know. So when you see that type of guy in breakdown or in a place of, you know, concern, not knowing what's next, things like that, it bothers you, truly. And it puts you in a place of, okay, what can I do? How can I help here? How can I be supportive to him? You know? And sometimes they just want you to listen. And they don't even know what they need in that moment. But it's nice to know that they could come to you whenever they were ready. So we have to just be prepared to listen. Because a lot of men, they may not do it often. They may not, you know, verbalize or be vulnerable in an emotional state often. So when they do, I know, I've seen this TikTok where this girl, her and her man were sitting on the couch. And then the dude just started talking and she went and got a blanket, food, and like pillows and just like, here, baby, just lay here, just lay here. And the caption was like, when your unemotional man starts to open up all of a sudden, essentially. And because I was like, that's me, baby. Please. Especially if I have felt like I can reach you. I felt like I can't connect with you. I feel like we're missing each other. We're not on the same page. I can't. I'm trying to be present for you, but you won't let me in. If I wake up and you ready to talk, oh, baby, what? I'm calling out of work because something's wrong at the house. Because we finna sit up and eat tacos until we have talked this through. Absolutely. You want to talk? Let's talk. Absolutely. I'll be ready. I'm telling you, when I have come out of a place or have been in a place of we not understanding each other, I don't like it. I feel like I'm talking to a brick wall. And then they open up, baby, whatever was on the calendar, it's off. It don't even matter no more. It's off. Over with. Because we got to address this right here. I got to be present for this right here. Right now. Yeah, for sure. For sure. So, I think for me, it's just a matter of being present, encouraging men, but not just during Men's Mental Health Awareness Month. We have to be present and encouraging to them on a regular basis and not just assume that they know it. Because they do that to us some days. We're like, well, you know how I feel about you. I ain't got to say it. Just like we need to hear it, so do they. So do they. They, like, and they may not even acknowledge that they're thankful for it, but it means a lot. It's if they're human, it means something when you're told you're doing a great job. I appreciate you being here. I appreciate you showing up. I appreciate you providing. I appreciate you just having our back. Even if that meant, like, you know, I was talking to one of my girlfriends a couple days ago, and her partner was just having a hard day, or just a hard couple of days, and she knew it. Like, they were just having a hard time. And so we were talking, and I was just like, okay, so what's their favorite dessert? Like, I don't know. But even something like that, like, if you know their favorite dessert is cookies and cream ice cream, and you got $5, baby, go to Publix, go to Walmart, go to CVS, get a small container of cookies and cream ice cream. Just have it at the house. Or just go, if they don't live with you, they just a really great friend of yours, they're a cousin, a brother, go take them a carton of ice cream. They may not need it, but they were on your mind. And it's a sign to say, hey, I got your back. I know you've been stressed out. I just want to let you know I'm here. Just make them feel better. They like thoughtful things just like we do. They just don't verbalize it as much. We'll be like, I want the flowers, the shoes, the food, the bag. And you got to tell me I'm beautiful 15 times a day. Minimum. Okay? Minimum. I need to hear that I'm your everything at least 14 times a day. Because what are you saying? Because what are you doing? Men are not that pressed. They just not. They just not. I could give an example, but I'm just not. Because it's going to make me laugh and I can't get through it. They're just not that pressed. But it does matter to them that they matter in your world. If you're a part of their world and they're a part of yours, it matters to them to know that they're making a difference in your life. So at least, if nothing else, acknowledge them, not just in June, but every month, every month. And it don't have to be nothing lavish. You ain't got to have a candlelight dinner every other Tuesday. It don't have to be nothing deep, but just something to say, hey, I don't know what I do with that big dog. And watch what it does for them. And how they start being more vocal and more vulnerable and more comfortable just to share and be present. And then once y'all have broken the barrier of just having vulnerable conversations in-house, then if they have not thought about it already, you could ease into a conversation of outside counseling and therapy. If they've been completely against therapy or assistance before because they don't want to be talking to a stranger or they don't feel comfortable or whatever the millions of reasons are, once they start getting vulnerable and comfortable, see. And if they say no, don't push the issue. But if they have enjoyed opening up and they feel like they're being heard, okay, would you be interested in bringing a third party into this conversation? Would you like me to come with you? I'll sit right next to you if you want me to. Or if you want to go by yourself, I can find recommendations. Just suggestions, not pressing the issue. If they say no, I'm good, then you continue to make cookies and cream ice cream at the house. And you sit right there. And they unload on you, you unload on them when it's your time. And y'all work it out. But if they open to it, let them talk. But we have to be able to pray, cover, and support these men like never before. There's like a full out war and attack on the black man. Full out. Full out. And so, that's gonna take me in a different direction. Help, Holy Ghost. I think that's why. I know that's why the enemy is like full all in attack mode when it comes to division in partnerships between genders or what have you. Because the way we as women can cover and pray for and like go against the thrones of darkness for the men in our lives, the enemy knows we won't have the real desire. It'll be harder for us to pray, rather, when we're upset with them. It's harder for me to go on into full out intercession for somebody I'm pissed off with. When we happy-go-lucky, we doing well, I'm going to tear up every demon in hell. But when I'm aggravated with you over something minute, or when I'm irritated, or when we have just had a whole debate, argument, whatever, I'm less inclined, and it's going to take me longer to work myself up to even pray over and for you. And if I'm your primary intercessor, whatever text was assigned for that day, they just going for it. And you coming home any kind of way, or you just fighting all kind of demons because I'm pissed off and I don't feel like praying. And so we as women, unfortunately, have to step out of our feelings some days and be like, okay, this is not about me. 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 The amount of times I have told the Lord, okay, this is not about me. This is not about me. This is not about me. Oh my God, it's not about me. And I had just to suck it up and pray and go up in prayer. Have been uncomfortable. But that's one less demon somebody had to fight. So I just want us to cover our men, pray for our men, believe God with them, and, you know, be a safe place for them. Now, you're not a safe place for all men, but there are certain men, your spouse, siblings, family members, whomever, that God has assigned you to be a safe place for. So be that. Be that. And then also encourage the men in your life to connect with the men in their life. Because even if they don't want to talk to us, they can at least talk to each other. And they'll learn when one opens up about some struggles, 9 times of 10, it's about 15 other ones that's dealing with the same thing. They just didn't know it because they didn't talk about it. There's so much power in conversation. Y'all know I harp on that. So that is a thing. But let's pray for our men. On a regular basis, for their mental health, their emotional health, their physical health, so they're not dying early out of stress-induced strokes and heart attacks. They live long, healthy lives so they can live to, you know, have families, have grandkids, and do well and not work themselves to death, but they're going to live well. We want that for them. We want that for them. So, yeah. That's that. But I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. I am finishing up a class next week or this week. And I'll be starting my last two classes at the end of next week. And we will be done August the 8th. Hondalo Shia. Now accepting Cash Apps and Zelles and Venmos and PayPals. Because what? I'm exhausted. But it's good. I'm excited. I'm physically tired, but I'm really excited in my spirit. Like I'm really, there's a 8-year-old child that is jumping up and down in the inside of me right now. Truly. I just got to get through it. But we got it. We're going to do well. And I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. We'll talk soon.